Hey everybody, I'm your professor, Stephanie Marin Rothman, and today we're going to talk about genetics, and I'm going to show you how to predict the offspring that are produced from certain crosses using Punnett squares. But before we do that, we need a little bit of background. We need to talk about meiosis and sexual reproduction first. So I'm going to do a little background first in this video, then the next video we'll show the actual Punnett squares. So right off the bat, meiosis, you should have already seen that lecture, but in case you forgot, the point of meiosis is to make gametes, which is a fancy word for sex cells, and that means eggs and sperm. So meiosis, you start off with a cell that's diploid, and you end up with cells that are haploid. So the cells in your body, like that make up you, they're all diploid. Di means two. So let me write that down. So diploid. So that di means two. So that means that you have two copies of chromosomes. Humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes in our diploid cells and the cells that are that make up our bodies, okay? So why do we have two pairs of, why do we have like pairs of chromosomes? Why do they come in twos? Because you got one from your mom and one from your dad, your biological mother, biological father, when they made you. Okay, I know you don't want to think about it, but that's where you came from, right? So those are the cells in your bodies. But the cells that you make when you do meiosis, the sperm and eggs, they're haploid, okay? Haploid, okay. That means just one chromosome. They don't come in pairs anymore, okay? So we actually write it like that. A diploid cell we write as 2N means diploid. A haploid cell we just write, actually just N, okay? It's haploid. So meiosis, use a different color, mix it up. So meiosis is starting with a diploid cell. So you start with a cell that's diploid, and you're making actually four cells that are haploid, okay? Start with diploid cells, end up with haploid cells. Okay, those are sperm and eggs. So meiosis makes sperm and eggs. Cool, because what's gonna happen and what we're gonna see when we do these crosses is a sperm and an egg are gonna fuse. So sperm, which is haploid, when they fuse together in fertilization, they make a baby, maybe. But they make the offspring, the next generation, which is now diploid, because you're combining two halves to make a whole. Okay, two halves make a whole. This is a process called fertilization, okay? Combining egg and sperm makes fertilization. All right, so that's a little bit of background on that. So that's meiosis. I mean, that's all well and good. We have sperm and egg combining, but what we're looking at now is the particular traits that are actually on those genes. Okay, so we're going to be seeing how, what is the probability of producing certain offspring based on the traits that the parents have, because you get a lot of your traits from your parents, right? That's the theory of heredity, is how traits are passed down from parent to offspring. So the point of a Punnett square is to show us the probability of certain offspring having particular traits based on the traits that the parents had and the genes that the parents had, okay? So you probably have heard about Mendel, Gregor Mendel, heard of that guy? He's really smart. He was like growing peas in his backyard. So we call him the father of genetics. Cool thing is he actually didn't know anything about like DNA, but he figured out inheritance. He figured out heredity. That's how traits are passed down from parent to offspring in particular ways. Cool thing, he figured this out before we knew anything about genes, which is pretty cool. He was really smart. So what he did, I'll draw it for you. So he would have these pea plants of all these different kinds of peas, all these different traits, and he would cross them and see what kind of offspring they got, then cross them together and see what kind of offspring they got. So what he did is the first generation, let's see, good. So the pea, what we call the pea generation for parent generation, he crossed, they were flowers that, should I just draw it? They were purple flowers. There we go. Boom, purple flowers. So he crossed purple flowers. They were what we call true breeding purple flowers. So what true breeding is that they come from a long line of purple flowers. Their parents are purple, their grandparents are purple, all their cousins are purple. All they are is purple in their entire family. So that's gonna mean something later on, but for right now, that's all we knew. He crossed them with a white flower. Ah, okay, so he crossed them. Can you see that that's purple and that's white? I'll write it down in case you can't see the color. Okay. Purple with white. Okay, so the next generation is F1. The F means filial, it just means kids. It means like the first kids. So what would you expect to see if you cross a purple flower with a white flower? Maybe like light purple would you expect? Would you expect like some kids to look like that parent, some to look like that parent? It's actually not what he saw at all. They were actually all purple. All of them, they're all purple. So that was kind of surprising. Even weirder, more things happened the next generation. So when he crossed these flowers with themselves, their brother, I mean, they're flowers, they don't care. He saw a certain pattern where three quarters, he saw this, well, it's a 3-to-1 ratio. So that means that 75% were purple. Okay. And 25% were white. Okay, so for like, so what the 3-to-1 means is every, for every three flowers that were purple, one was white. Okay, so 3/4 or 75% of the babies were purple and 25% of the babies were white. Okay, and he actually saw this with a bunch of different traits. He looked at like the, you know, the peas color and the peas like texture and like, you know, all these other traits. And he always saw the same pattern where you cross two parents that are, that the traits are totally different. The next generation, they all took after only one of the parents. But then the following generation, this trait came back. It's kind of like this color, the white color, skipped a generation. It came back in this generation down here. At this, it's consistently this 3-to-1 ratio. We saw this over and over and over again with all these different traits. So there's lots going on, and we're going to kind of work backwards. I'm going to show you in a Punnett Square how he got that, and also how you can use this knowledge to predict other traits. So a couple like key words we're going to use. I have room here. Is a genotype, okay? Genotype are the genes, and the phenotype is like the physical. Sloppy. So the genotype is the genes. So the genes are what codes for certain traits, right? Like the genes, you remember that's in your DNA. Your DNA doesn't like do anything per se. It's just the instructions on how to build you, right? Remember, it's all in your cells and your nuclei. So the phenotype is what those genes actually code for. So like the phenotypes is the flower color here. It's either white or purple. Those are the phenotypes. But what's there that we can't see are the genes. We can't see the genes. It's on the DNA. We can see the flowers physically. We can see that. But what's making those flowers either purple or white are the genes, and that's their genotype. Okay. Genes come in different flavors called alleles. Alleles are different flavors of genes. So the alleles, for these next crosses I'm going to show you, there's only two flavors. There's two kinds of alleles. It does get more complicated, but we're going to keep it simple from the beginning. So there's two different kinds of alleles, two different flavors of genes. One's dominant and one's recessive. So the allele, okay, is either dominant or recessive. And we have either uppercase or lowercase. Okay, those are the two different flavors, two different alleles. Now, how many alleles do you have? How many copies of the gene do you get when you are built? You get two, right? You got one from dad's sperm, one from mom's egg. So you get two copies. So if you get two copies of the gene and you get two dominant alleles, okay, then we say that you're homozygous. Oh, whoop, missed an M. Oh God, homozygous dominant. Okay, homo means the same. So homozygous dominant means you got two dominant alleles, okay? That's your genotype, Okay, is homozygous dominant, that's your genotype. If you got one dominant allele and one recessive allele, they're different, you got two different flavors. Heterozygous. Hetero means different. So heterozygous, that means that you got two different kinds of alleles, okay? If you got two recessive alleles, they're both the same again, homozygous, but now it's recessive because you got two recessive alleles. So these are all genotypes right here. These are the, these are the three genotypes for these different crosses. So let's pause here. In the next video, I'll show you how we'll do the Punnett squares for this particular cross, okay?